Everybody, it's Invicta, and it's time for Wacky Wednesday. Yeah, your eyes are not deceiving you. Today, we're going to be playing as Jacob and Esau, one of the more hotly requested character runs that people have been posting lately because they're going through unlocks and they're trying to have, or they're having some difficulties with this character or characters, and I don't blame you because it's Jacob and Esau. You know what to expect, but before we get anywhere, I want to say thank you all very much for all the support on the Isaac videos. We have a couple videos still on the cusp of 5,000 likes, but not quite there. So again, if you want to support my channel, definitely go back and check out those videos. And of course, you don't even have to watch them. If you just go back and click the like button, that's good enough for me. So here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by Garth Shark. Again, one of my favorite names to read. Title of thread was, "It do be like this sometimes." Okay, I have a little bit of a bone to pick with this one because Chaos and M can't actually like kill you. Okay, unless if you like M into like Plan C or something like that. But TM Trainer, even though it is fun, it is the ultimate chaotic nature in Isaac. It can still pretty much kill you at any moment, especially if you get like Damocles or something. Or it just decides to kill you, so. But anyway, thank you very much, Garth Shark, because I still love the pool meme. It is great. So here we go. Oh, man. Jacob and Hee Haw. How long has it been? CJ is going to be the name that it's the sound that I make whenever I play Jacob and Esau. It's Clegg. Ugh. Something like that. So here we go. What is Jacob and Esau? How do they work? And why are there two of them? Well, this character is the first tandem character that's really ever been produced in Isaac. Of course, we had the Forgotten, but the Forgotten and the Soul don't play at the same time. Obviously, you can switch back and forth between them, whereas Jacob and Esau are on the screen simultaneously. And you might think, like, whoa, hey, wait a second. That seems, like, pretty good. Like, why would that be bad? You have double the fire rate. You've got two characters, two life pools. Like, how bad could that be? It's not really... In all seriousness, it's not really that bad in practice. In principle, I should say. But in practice, there's a problem with the fact that if you die on one, you die on the other. You can see the stats over here, by the way. Jacob is the one that's on top. Esau is the one that's on bottom, even though the red character that you see here, this is Jacob, and that is Esau over there. You can't move them independently from one another. I'm going to give Hee Haw the tiers up just to get our tiers rate even with Pisces, and I also like the knockback here. So there's, you know, from a strategy layer, there are certain things that you can do with them that is actually really cool, especially getting, like, dual. You get to have the dual item pedestals that you can go down to in Downpour with, and I'll probably, I don't know if I'm going to end up doing that or not. I might show you all. It's more important just to kind of show like how these two characters play, because a lot of people do have problems with them, including myself. Like I don't play them nearly as much as I should because I just absolutely hate the character. But I understand that, you know, there are people who've been not ever wanting to play Jacob and Esau, but they still want to get like just you want to get a feel for the character and see exactly like what the deal is. So it's, you know, I get it. And, I mean, you have to get the unlocks, too. So they have one of the best unlocks in the entire game, which, of course, is Rock Bottom. You may have also noticed that whenever we laid down those bombs earlier to get Pisces, that both of them laid down a bomb. So you get double the bombs for the cost of one, basically. I don't know how that ended up hitting Hee Haw, because I thought that Jacob was in front of him, but there we go. One thing that you'll frequently see me do is line them up basically side by side or on top of each other almost. This is for dodging purposes, and also it's easier to try to meld them into one singular character than not. So I'm going to give this to Hee Haw just because I want him to have I basically want him to have just all the defense. We need to go into the cursed room here, and I need to make sure we use Jacob. So if you're playing on mouse and keyboard, you can hold control and have independent use of Jacob. I'm going to actually use Hee Haw. Oh, no, this is Jacob. Okay, there we go. Well, I was hoping to do this without having to be charged any HP here. Let me put Esau over this side. And then what I'll do is I'll take Jacob and go up to the top right like this. See if I can diagonal it. Here we go. So that's only going to cost us half of a red heart, but unfortunately we didn't get any money or anything like that out of there. So there's the half red heart that we have in the boss room that we can use to act as the payment for the curse room. And then that'd be that. Secret room's right there, by the way, but we have no bombs, so. And, yep, away we go. Yeah, let's show them the double item pedestal. Why not? So here we are on floor two. With devil deals and stuff, I honestly wouldn't even worry about devil deals unless if you just have a surplus of damage or HP early on these two characters, which you probably won't, to be honest. Go for angel deals if you can, because angel deals, you can take multiple item pedestals in the same time. And that's what, did you see that tear fly right over us? And that's what's most important about Jacob and Esau is surviving. You want to make one of them. It kind of depends on what your playstyle is. On one hand, you want to make one of them so powerful that you can't possibly fail, and you just destroy every room, and there's no problem with worrying about damage or whatnot. On the other end, you can say that you want to have them balanced, and that way they're both equally powerful. But this is not a tainted Lazarus sort of situation here, because both of them are on the screen at the same time. I think we're just gonna fight the boss right now. Rainmaker is not who I wanted to see, especially in this arena too. And so you see that Esau was drifting away from Jacob there a little bit. Yeah, and there goes a devil deal, and that's Jacob and Esau in all of their goodness right there. Is Jacob? It's either Jacob or Esau getting stuck on a corner or something like that, and then you getting hit, and that's just how it goes. That's what ultimately makes this character so annoying to play is that there's so many ways for one or the other to get completely stuck, and this is another reason why that I try to layer them on top of each other as much as possible. Even though you can't get directly on top of one another, it still makes it much more manageable movement-wise. But remember, they also can get caught up on like a corner, like that right there, as I just showed you as an example. And then you try to maneuver Esau, but you inadvertently get Jacob stuck, and then, you know, everything just it gets into a chaotic mess. So, and I am a bit rusty playing these two characters too. So, you know, got a key here. I was really hoping we get a bomb for that tinted rock. Probably actually shouldn't be destroying these poops now that I see the spike rocks there. But the whole reason why we came down to Downpour was so we can show you the dual item pedestal mechanic. Even though one item is going to be blind, it is against my nature. But when you're playing a Jacob and Esau run, you gotta go for broke. Desperate times call for desperate measures, sort of thing. And remember, if one dies, they both die. There's no reason for us to go into the store right now. We could still go in the curse room because we have Jacob's HP. We don't want to lose this half soul heart on Esau if we can help it. Now, if you ask me, would I rather play Jacob and Esau or Tainted Jacob, I'll take Jacob and Esau 100 times over. So we get spin down die, which I'm going to put on Jacob. So you basically have to line them up perfectly, and since they share the same movement speed, they can take both pedestals at the same time. One gets spin down die, the other gets a little Loki. It doesn't matter because we failed the devil deal, so we're still going to have the devil deal chance anyway. So spin down die, you know it, I know it, we love it. Gives you so many options. You don't even have to really qualify for devil deals anymore. It just depends on what items you see. Now this is going to definitely be a little bit wild here with the double item pedestals in the next level. Sorry about that. So I'm very, very keen to see what we get here. All right, one bomb gets us two keys here, but I'd rather save the bomb, to be honest. Eden's Blessing turns into pay to play. Eden's Blessing's pretty good for a Tears Up as well. We're going to give that to Hee-Haw, probably. Let's do this. I don't want to hit these spikes, but you know we're probably going to. Okay, so that... So we don't... I don't know what this turns into. Turns into Jell-O. It could also turn into spooky bombs and then eventually IBS. You can use space bar items on Esau if you want to. Lieutenant Rock in there? No. Wait, was there? No. I don't really recommend it for anything important. And Jell-O to me is not... Like, it's better to have like an HP generator or invincibility or something like that. Than an actual active item, in my opinion, on Esau, just because it is kind of wonky to operate two of them. It all comes down to practice, and really that's what Isaac is in general. I'm trying to burn them here. There we go. Okay, so there's a Tinted Rock, which I am going to use, and I'm also going to use Jacob's bomb to get into the secret room. Okay, that's pretty offensive there, game, but all that, we use a bomb and anyway. A little bit mad that we only get a card out of that. We can't get into the store, but we will get a charge on spin down. So this is either going to give us five bombs, or we can use it from whatever drops from the boss. But we got to be a little bit careful here, just because we don't want to necessarily get a devil deal. But Wormwood's kind of a nightmare anyway. Gonna layer him like this. Yep, and there it goes. And again, that's just how it goes. It's par for the course with these guys. And not getting any soul hearts from that Tinted Rock was also kind of the death of this devil deal. So we get Cat of Nine Tails, which is fantastic for us. Jacob really suffers from damage, so I'm going to give that to him. We did finally get a soul heart here, so we'll have at least a chance for it on the next round. But we pretty much, if we want to keep going alt path here, I'm not going to fight Mother. It's not my intention to actually go through with an alt path run, but I wanted to get the double item pedestals at the very least. So we get spooky bombs. Ghost bombs are going to give us five bombs here, and then we can get keys. I'm going to park Esau here. We go. We could probably get away with spending a bomb in there. It's two bombs for the price of one. Yeah, that was worth it. We'll give this one to Hee-Haw. There we go. I'm not going to go into the store because I really don't think that it's necessary. We don't have enough money to do anything, really. I am going to go alt path here. So it costs us one bomb. Sometimes there is a tinted rock in here as well. Good. Nice. And there's fool's gold. I will use this bomb for. Okay, so we have 8 cents. That is enough to convince me to go check out the store. So you see some of the positives that you can get out of Jacob and Esau. It's just they're few and far between. And it's just a wonky play style is the reason why most people, including myself, don't really like it. How are we gonna do this here? I can place the bomb and then run out the door with Jacob. Then we can come back in. There we go. And here, we don't have to have any guesswork. We can just push the chest over to the other one. The secret room can't be over there because it was encased with rocks. So, there we go. I think this would be worth it, especially if we just get one bomb back. Okay. I'm going to give that to Esau. Lead pencil, fantastic. Fantastic item indeed. And another soul heart. Honestly, I'm fine with that. We'll give it to Jacob. And what did this... Okay, it was brown nugget. We could buy a full charge, but we're going to get a full charge on the next floor anyway, so... and the secret room should be here. One more bomb, and we could have gotten into the curse room as well. I mean, we have a full card. It would cost us one. It would cost us one half of a soul heart. No, we want to go in with Jacob. Okay, let's give that back to Jacob, and then we'll use Esau's full card. So you use the, again, if you're on mouse and if you're on keyboard, not mouse, but if you're on keyboard, if you hold control, that swaps over to Esau's controls, and then you use the corresponding key, which in this case is Q. Curse the Unknown. Going into the mines here is a little bit scary. It's been, I don't know how long it's been since I've done alt path with these two. But this was one of the more requested characters lately. And I think that most people know that I just don't like Jacob and Esau at all. So, you know, it's good to get a Jacob and Esau run in every couple of months. Super Sloth. Nice little volley there from the 8-inch, or the, not 8-inch pencil, but the lead pencil. What's that, 8-inch nails? I will take that, put this on Hee-Haw. Now remember, we have spin down dies, so we have more options here than it looks like. It's just that we don't know what we're, we just don't know what we're rolling for in the Curse of the Blind. We got knocked into the fire there by the recoil of the stone host. The secret room might be there. I think it is there. You gotta be careful of the flame diglets in here. The meat wheels aren't usually too bad unless they catch on fire. If you can keep them away from the fires, then you'll be alright. I don't know where this last one is. No, it's on fire, of course. There we go. It's good to extinguish fires like this. Avoiding environmental hazards on this character is paramount. So I'm pretty sure that the secret room's there, but right now we're more focused on trying to get the item room. A lead pencil was a big, big boost of power. Okay, the rosary turns into mini mush, turns into growth hormones, but I want to take the rosary anyway, and I'm gonna put it on Esau just because he's got lead pencil. Should be lined up. Sissy! How you doing, Sissy? Little Sissy. Showing up for a Jacob and Hee-Haw run. Oh, man. Good thing we didn't spin down die that. Blind little Sissy. Rosary is a good tiers upgrade and HP upgrade for Esau as well. The cross-eyed, those cross-eyed fly bombs there, the fire bombs, they will always go in a directional X pattern, not a cross pattern. Oh, God. We got probably the most annoying boss to fight other than Gideon on Jacob and Esau. Hopefully we can kill one of them quickly without them splitting too much. Okay, good, yeah. We'll be fine in here then. Yeah, this tough twins can be annoying because of if you split them, especially with all the rocks, you see how easy it is for... Excuse me? What was over here that hit us? There must have been a fly that I must have missed. But you see how easy it is for these two to get stuck on all the rocks that are in here? Tropicamide, sure. And we will go... I mean, at this point, we might as well check out the devil deal. Okay, Cricket's body. The Bible. And Satanic Bible. Bible turns into... I can't tell what that is. I don't know if that's... I'm not sure if that's Jacob's or Juice's shadow. Satanic Bible is not bad for Jacob for Esau, but the problem is that remember it's going to usurp our boss items. But with Spin Down Die, it's a different story. Cricket's body would not be horrible either. I think we take the Satanic Bible. And then use it. And then we use Spin Down. No, it's a double tiers up. Okay. Yeah, we need the tiers up here. Cricket's body is a pretty big tiers up and a range down for Jacob. We'll take both of them. All right. Well, things just got very interesting here. Let's go back and we're playing with fire now because both of them are on low HP, but we significantly increased their damage output. And Esau now has the Satanic Bible, which can give us those very important HP generators that we know and love. So let's get this. There's the Bible again, thanks to the rosary. Let's buy this for Esau and get him juiced up. I didn't want to blow up the reroll machine, but that's fine. And now, actually, this secret room's right there, by the way. If we can get a bomb, we can get in there. Get a soul heart. Need to give that to Jacob. Look at Sissy charming the stones off of that one. And this is equally appealing as well because remember we're getting charges off of the Satanic Bible, so. Good. I'm encouraged by what happened on this floor. Super secret rooms to the left of, or to the right of that room, by the way. But we'll head on down. Sorry about that. Had a phone call with Mama Victa. So we're still doing okay on HP here. And again, having the Satanic Bible doesn't necessarily mean that we're giving up on our boss items yet. And again, the main determining factor there was the fact that we have Spin Down Die. Spin Down Die is still gives us a layer of forgiveness when it comes to re-rolling. Back out just because I'm not even going to mess with it. All that smoke in there. Oh, this is not what you want to see on Jacob and E-Haul here. It's best just to do this with just Jacob and not try to force the issue with trying to get He-Haw to do it. There we go. So we could go into the curse room here. Esau actually has more HP. So I'm going to try to get him into the curse room. And we get euthanasia, which is totally fine. We need to give this to Esau. Esau has the better firepower. He also has the he's also got the splash damage and the splash shots from Cricket's body. So getting those euthanasia shots out is going to be imperative later on. And we also, of course, have the full charge on the spin down die. So things are looking relatively smooth so far anyway, but with Jacob and Esau, it can all go downhill very quickly. So you gotta be careful. It's not necessarily as dangerous as playing as Tainted Loss or something like that, but especially when we have stats like these, but it can be. That kind of holds true for every character in Isaac when you really think about it. Super Envy is not gonna have a chance here against the splash damage and the lead pencil shots from Jacob and Esau here. Sissy going in there charming everything. Charm's very good against Super Envy. Little Sissy. You knew it was going to be a blessed run as soon as she showed up. Making it happen on a Wednesday, Sissy. At some point, we need to try to swap. Oh, man. If we can get Cricket's head out of this, this would be fantastic. We need to be cautious about... what we take with this blind item here. A tears up would be nice, but we're already suffering a huge, huge tears down. From Cricket's head. So Cricket's body, however, gives us a massive amount of damage, which we'll have to put on Esau. Oh, I'm actually surprised it still hit. Now I'm hoping that we get a spacebar item just so we can swap the Satanic Bible and spin down die between these two. That way we can start juicing up Jacob's HP a little bit here. So all we need is one full charge, and we get access to Cricket's head. Which again, we definitely want to give to Esau just because of his damage output. A little bit lacking right now. Humbling Bundle turns into Midas Touch, which we don't really want. Doesn't really matter who we put that on. Remember, we're buying two bombs for the price of one here, but it's unfortunate that we didn't get a full charge. I'm going to be real salty if we don't get a full charge here if we miss Cricket's head. Okay, we are going to get a full charge here.
Wow.
If we're going to take damage, it needs to be on Esau, not Jacob. There we go. use the Satanic Bible one more time on Esau, and then hopefully Spin Down Die will give us a space bar item that we can just swap to. We're still going to stick with Spin Down Die, of course. Oh, I'm an idiot. I was too excited to even think about the double item pedestal. All right, well, never mind. That's my dang on that one. I was too excited and totally forgot that it's not going to work like that. What? Ah, you have to pick the right one. Okay. Definitely need to give this to Jacob. He's hurting in the HP department. All right, so Esau's damage goes up to 7, and unfortunately we manifested a Great Gideon fight. Shouldn't be too bad with his damage, though. We need to get rid of these rocks if possible. Just need to have a clear path to the enemies before Gideon can do anything. The euthanasia shots that I was talking about earlier. Really making their value known here. That turns into missing no, which we don't want. I mean, dark matter is a good damage upgrade, but we really got to be careful with we've got to be careful with Jacob's HP here. But Dark Matter is a good damage upgrade, so I can't pass that up. Curse of Lost. Back up here on the light side of path now. That was a good romp through the alt path for sure, and it kind of shows you just how good it can be with these two. But it can also be very bad, because obviously alt path is way more challenging than regular path. I think we've had enough of blue spikes for this week. So 28 minutes to mom, it's about right. This is my favorite Jared Leto side project, by the way. Man, we get an Emperor card here. Absolutely, we'll take that. I still am going to hold on to the Strength card. I mean, there's no reason not to use the Ace of Clubs, of course, because, I mean, it executes an entire room and gives us bombs. What we really need to do is find an HP generator or a spacebar item at the very least, so that we can put it on Jacob and swap these two for now. We still need, I mean, I'm going to keep up with the use of the Satanic Bible for Hee-Haw, though, because obviously we want to try to keep his HP up. There's our Fool card, and yeah. Yeah, give that to Jacob for sure. We have a lot of burst damage between the two, though, and I'm really encouraged by that. We want this to be a 5 room. No. Lots of money, though. No, we do not want to reroll this. Absolutely not. We have crafted a very, very powerful run here. No way I'm going to reroll this. And we still have potential to get it even crazier with the presence of Spin Down Die. Super secret room, which means mom is right up here. So we need to find the store, more importantly, the item room. Esau's HP is now going through the roof, and that's good. That's where we want him to be. Get Black Candle, which I definitely do want. Pay to win or pay to play turns into missing no, which we don't want, or dark matter, which we could take. Yeah, and there's the Bonafide Genuine Sinvicta Gourmet Premium Level Disney Plus style full clear for you. Despite having Curse the Lost. It's amazing, isn't it? So we took the more balanced approach here to dispersing the stats between these two. And this is the result. You have two... Oh, there's a creep there. You have two competent characters. That's tempting. Esau would be one away from Spun, even though Adrenaline's not that great. We might as well finish off the full clear because you never know if we're going to get an item pedestal or, yeah, Tinted Rock here for sure. Whoa, I didn't know that there were going to be enemies in here. It's my dang on that one, fellas. I had no idea needles are going to spawn in that room. It's a very odd, very, very odd room, or it's an odd place for the secret room. Agreed. Hoping Steam Sale drops. Didn't. Okay, so let's see what, well, we can go into the curse room as well, because, I mean, again, Esau has plenty of HP here. Wheel of Fortune. Hierophant card. Absolutely. That's a Jacob. Okay, and we still have our Emperor card. And a Wheel of Fortune strength card. Okay. Let's lead off with Esau because he's got the HP generator. Now we're looking very solid. Spin down die still has two charges because of the full charge in here. So that turns into Papula Duplex, which turns into number two, which I don't want. I wouldn't mind Papula Duplex, to be honest. We can give that to. I mean, it would be better. It would be better with Esau. And then we can, instead of getting another soul heart here, I'm gonna get a charge on the spend on die, and then give Jacob the soul heart. So we're making it happen here, with despite us not having an HP generator on Jacob, it's still coming around to be pretty darn powerful. And I don't care about the fool card. We have our Emperor card. Mom shouldn't even blue mom's not gonna have a really big chance against these two. And definitely don't feel guilty if you end up juicing one more than the other. So now, a nice thing about this is that we can also take the Polaroid and the negative at the same time. Which allows us to do. Well, I'll show you in a second. We can give ourselves a damage upgrade here on Jacob, because he needs it more than Esau does. There you go. So we get a damage up on the negative. They get both the powers of the negative and the Polaroid. And this turns into Twisted Pear. Oh man, we put this on Hee Haw and we're happy. Yeah, give that to Esau for sure. Esau is starting to get real, real powerful now. Good. We're looking good. Despite some early game jitters and losing out on a couple of devil deals here, we've quickly gotten back in the swing of things. Twisted Pairs is going to multiply the amount of shots that we do by a whole lot. And it's basically going to pay for itself in three full charges. Because it's doubtful that Esau is going to get hit by pretty much anything. And that's where lead pencil really comes out as a good offensive-defensive item as well. And remember, we have this Emperor card, too, so... Just get him out of here. Remember that euthanasia will execute anything that's killable, and even some things that are unkillable. So you can just freely, continually fire against a target, even if it has like a shield in front of it or something like that, or a host. Super greed. Super dead. Look at that, we get a curse room as well. I tell you what, all things come together whenever you got little sissy helping you out. So that turns into Binge Eater. I don't actually want it though, because Binge Eater is going to screw up spin down die. I know I said I don't want Binge Eater, but it also kills our movement speed, which is actually really, really dangerous. I mean, I'm going to keep giving it to Esau, because he's got the more powerful build right now. And if he becomes Guppy, then man, I think they both become Guppy. It doesn't really matter. See here, the euthanasia shots can also destroy the vis chub heads here. Man, that is some power right there from Esau. Now, a spin down die, you know, the prospect of doing a victory lap here is pretty appealing, just because we can see how crazy this can get. So we might do a victory lap here. Although the video is already 42 minutes long. We'll see how long it takes us to get there. Sanguine Bonds turns into Sacred Orb, which I will take. And I'm going to keep putting this on Esau, just because he has the renewable source of HP. Oh, man. Now we're getting scary. Alright, so again, strategy stays the same. Gonna layer them on top of each other here to try to make all of our tiers come from one singular spot on the screen, instead of having to split up and get stuck on stuff. Makes it easier to dodge as well. Gotta say that Esau's face looks absolutely horrifying. Guppy's eye. And really, this is, you know, we've been playing pretty well with dodging. It hasn't been that difficult, obviously, because we have an overwhelming amount of offense that we're using. Sometimes there's a Tinted Rock hiding in that room. Basically get four bombs for the price of one. Seagram might be to the left of here. Oh. I don't remember if I've already tried that or not. Bella's Chub. She ain't got no butt. Look at Sissy just Sissy's just sitting there judging. Alright, Sissy. Alright. You know, once again, Esau has basically paid for every Devil Deal item he's taken. First bit of damage there on Jacob in a while. You gotta be careful with damage on Jacob, though. do get a devil deal. I'm going to give this back to Jacob. Just to make that up. I mean, we can swap them now, but we got to give this to, we have to give this to Esau, but we're definitely going to take a hit on the spikes here. Yeah. I don't even care about honestly using it. Okay, so 2 or 3 for Guppy. Yeah. Like, I could have taken Eye of a Cult, obviously, but I'm a little bit spooked by the HP loss right now, and we don't really need it. Pretty much, I mean, it's good that Jacob took the hit in there and not Esau. We don't want to get low life between these two. Not until, well, not ever, but I mean, definitely we need to get our HP back up on Esau. And Satanic Bible is going to help us do that, along with our offense keeping us safe in these late game stages here. So we have a decent shot at getting Guppy here, going into the dark chest. Yeah, we can take the death card. Okay, they apparently just didn't care about that. All right. All right, that was unexpected. We can bomb these skulls as well, just to see if we can get a couple of extra black soul hearts. Or not. Notice the switch of the target prioritization there. I didn't notice that there was an eye laser on the right side until, like, halfway making my way into the screen there. Again, I think that we can use the bombs here for greater gain. And by that, I mean just spawning a bunch of hosts, because black soul hearts don't exist. All right, so we didn't really make up enough HP for me to feel comfortable taking a Guppy item on the next floor. Unless if it's 9 lives with Esau, which I don't know if, I'm not sure if that's still bugged or not, but. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. We need to make sure we don't take damage here on Satan. Okay. I see we went to the lamb school of schmoving here. All right, that was certainly something there, Stanley. Gotta admit. All right, I don't know what any of these turn into, but unless if it's 9 lives, we don't really care. I mean, there's 9 lives there, but it's a little bit too little, too late. Heartbreak rolls in the swarm. Little Horn turns into Large Zit. Dark Bum turns into a little haunt, and then the shovel turns into the nail, turns into the Lord of the Pit, and then turns into nine lives. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna make it there. That's okay. I think that I'm satisfied here with a lamb kill. We had a really, really solid run with Jacob and Esau, and that's not something that you can say like every single day. So I'll take a lamb kill with Jacob and Seesaw. I don't think that we need to do a victory lap. It was pretty long, and my voice is actually kind of bothering me today. But hey, look at that. You got yourself a J&E run. So hopefully you all enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you click the like button. Leave a comment down below. Let me know what your favorite strategy is when you're playing Jacob and Esau. Do you like playing the one is overpowered one? Do you like having the equal distribution strategy? You know, all that stuff is pertinent. So thank you for watching, everyone. I really hope you enjoyed it. Like I said, if you did, make sure you click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And, of course, subscribe if you're not already a member of the Mosh Pit here. And if you want to go the extra length, you can also leave a super thanks down below as well. I am planning on compiling a list together of all the super thankers and then probably going to read them off on, like, Sunday's episode or something like that. Haven't really decided how I'm going to fully implement that. But I thank you for those of you who have already done that. Hope you had a great start to your midweek here in the Mosh Pit. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Relat01, Troy Mason, Dragoroth, Lewis GLB, and Lauren Strand. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of the Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta. It was actually Dragorth, not Dragoroth. Sorry, Dragorth. Thank you, Dragorth.